Hello. Recently I've been working with methods to quickly deploy Microsoft Windows systems. I have a Windows 7 image file that was previously prepared using a reference computer which has all the baseline applications and Microsoft updates installed. The reference system was then transferred to an image file following Microsoft's Sysprep and ImageX procedures. The resulting image file can be copied to a bootable flash drive for easily cloning other computers. There are lots of other videos that demonstrate the Sysprep and ImageX procedures, but in this video I will show you how to deploy a Microsoft image file using a bootable flash drive. The flash drive used here is a SanDisk Extreme USB 3.0, which was made bootable using the Hiren's boot CD version 15.1. The Hiren's boot CD also contains lots of other programs such as partitioning agents, disk cloning and imaging tools, and many other programs for fixing various computer problems. With a bootable USB flash drive that has the image file and these programs, I will demonstrate how you can quickly deploy a complete Windows operating system to various hardware systems. Using a virtual machine, we're going to boot up into the Hiren's boot menu. And there it is. So we're going to go down to the Windows Mini 7, select that, and down to Windows 7. This will load a Windows 7 portable environment like Windows PE. Booting up in this environment is a little bit slower than coming up in Windows XP, PE. It's a little bit slower, so you have to be patient. It's loading a lot more tools. Okay, it's coming in here. This is what the desktop looks like when it first boots up. So we'll take a look at the Hiren boot menu. And this is a rebuild version, so there's additional tools on here that you would normally not get from the website. This version was quite hard to find, but there'll be a link at the bottom of the video. First thing we're going to do is go into Partition Wizards and take a look at the partition. You can see that it's unallocated. It's a 60 gig hard drive. That's our target drive. Close that. Now we're going to go open up a DOS prompt. And we're going to go into Diskpart. This version of Diskpart is unique to Windows 7. It's the newer version. Okay, we're going to select Disk 0. And we're going to clean. It wipes off everything. And then we're going to create partition primary with a size equal to 100 megabytes. And this will contain the boot sector. Okay. Now we need to select partition 1. And then we need to format with FS equals NTFS quick and label this system. Okay. Now we need to make it active. This is part of the boot process. I'm going to create another partition, partition 2. It's a primary partition. And here you can see there's no size. It's going to use the entire rest of the volume. Okay. Now we need to select partition 2. We need to format it. Again, it's going to be NTFS. Quick. And the label will equal Windows. Takes a minute. Okay, that's done. So now we need to assign letter for the partition. We'll make that C. And then we'll exit and close this. I'm done here. Now let's go back in to the partition wizard and take a look. You can see now that we have a system volume or a system partition of 100 megs, and the OS will be on the second partition, which is 59.9 gigs. Close that. Okay, let's go take a look at other drives that we have. Here's the C. You can see there's nothing on C drive. It's completely empty. And this is our flash drive, our USB flash drive that we've booted from. I've stored this folder here that contains the WIM image. Go in there and take a look. It's in this folder. That's it. You can see it's about 7 gigs. Quite large. Okay, so that's what we have to work with. Now we're ready to install the WIM image. We're going to go down to Windows Installation, Windows NT Setup, and use this program. You can see the green boot sectors. That's good. If something's wrong with what you've done, it'll be red. It's a flag. So let's select the WIM file. It's on the thumb drive. There it is. Okay, we're going to select that. And you can see it populates the options addition information down below. This is a Windows 7 64-bit Ultima. Second thing is the boot sector. We need to go and make sure we're selecting system partition, E. It is. And then we'll go down to the installation drive and select that. And that's going to be the Windows drive. Okay. We're ready to go. You say next, you get this boot sector update, and we want to use this tool's ability to update the boot sector. Normally, we'd have to do this in DOS. We'll say OK. And it starts applying the image. Now, this will take a little while to do, so we're going to fast forward this. Now, depending on your hardware, this could be quite fast with a 3.0 USB. But again, we're doing this in a virtual environment, so it's going to be a little bit slower. So we will fast forward this. There we are. We're done. It's finished imaging it. And it tells us that we need to reboot, and then it's going to begin the Sysprep phase. If you've prepared your WIM image correctly, you'll be booting up like first time use. So now we basically need to just remove the thumb drive and restart. Okay. So now post Sysprep phase starting here. And I'm going to speed this process up as well because this takes quite a bit of time to go through all of this. Loading drivers and such. So we're fast forwarding this. Again, I wanted you to see what it's like when Sysprep is starting up first time. It goes through and recognizes all the devices, installs the correct drivers. Now, if you don't, some hardware may require you to install additional drivers. But for the most part, everything will be there. We're at 78%, 79, there we go. And it goes through a series of restarts here. Here we go, finally, it's booted up. First prompt, we're gonna just select all the defaults here. Username, computer name. Call it anything you want here. Again, this machine is not going to be joining a domain, it's just in a work group. Click next. I'm going to just select all the defaults to get quickly through this. Ask me later. Whatever you want here. And we'll select work group. Okay, now it's finalizing the setup. Okay, that has finished. And now we see the logon prompt. This is the admin account. We'll go ahead and log in. And it will prepare the desktop for first time use. And this always takes a little bit longer initially when you first log in. It's setting things up for the first time. So we'll wait on that. And then we'll take a look around. Okay, let's take a look at the computer hard drive space. You can see now that we're using about 19.3 gigs, and that was from the 7.1 gig WIM file. And our programs are all here. We've got an antivirus program right from the start. And we've also got the Microsoft Office suite that I've installed. All of that from my reference computer. And that's easily deployed. So we'll just shut down and log off. And thank you for watching.